Hi guys, today I have an elf haul for you. I just got a few little things off of their website recently and I thought I would show you guys what I had picked up. I just got it yesterday so I haven't really tried everything out yet, but I just thought I would haul it for you. So one of the reasons why I actually needed to order some stuff from e.l.f. is because I ran out of the e.l.f. Eye Brightener in the color Buff. I like to use it to set my under eye concealer, so I picked up another one of those. It actually has enough color to it to actually, like, blend in the concealer. Like, if you only put the concealer, like, so close to your lash line, and then you use this powder to kind of blend in between, or if you do your eye makeup first, and then you go into your face makeup and concealer and stuff like that, it's a very nice color to actually get a nice blend in between your eye makeup and your face makeup, if that makes any sense. If you always do your foundation first and then your eyes afterward, you don't know what I'm talking about. But if you do your eyes first and you like to have a nice blend in between your eyes and your face, I'm just rambling, but hopefully somebody knows what I'm talking about here. This is really nice for that because it's a perfect, really light color. It's a little bit of color to give an extra bit of concealerness to it, but not too much that it's like a concealer all on its own. Alright, enough about that one. I also ordered an e.l.f. Mineral Concealer, and this is in the lightest color, but it doesn't even tell me what it is. It's like light or fair or something like that. So I ordered this thinking it would be like similar to this, but it's like a giant container and I'm pretty sure they're around the same price. So this is a way better deal if it works just as well. So I'm excited to try this out just to see how it goes. This is a big old container for a concealer if you ask me. Oh, another reason why I really needed to order some stuff from e.l.f. is because they came out with a few new brushes. This here is the contouring brush. It's a short, stubby, little, densely packed contour brush to get right in there, get really nice chiseled cheekbones, and I used it this morning and it was like a dream. It was so easy to use and it blended really nicely too. I thought maybe it might be kind of hard to blend because it is a little bit thin here, but it actually worked really nicely, really quick and super easy to use. I enjoy this one a lot and I might have to pick up another one because this one's very, very cool. It's cool to see this kind of brush. It's like, it's very, not necessarily unique because I know that NARS has like a little flat one kind of deal like this, but just very cool and new and interesting, I think. And then the other little brush guy that I wanted to get was the Duo Eyebrow, what's it called? Eyebrow Duo Brush, and it has on one end a little, I don't know if you can see, a little angled brush, and then on the other end a tiny little baby spoolie for doing your eyebrows, and it's all in one little thing. So I think this is super cool, gonna be very excited to use this one. I actually tried out another eyebrow product for this morning, so I didn't get to try this out. This here is the e.l.f. Instant Lift Brow Pencil in the color Natural Brown. I want to say it was like the medium brown on the website. It's got your little spoolie guy on this end. It's a little bit bigger kind of spoolie compared to the little spoolie on this brush. And then on the other end, you've got a retractable eyebrow pencil. So this here is the medium brown, like I said, but I have it on today, and I think it's a really nice color match for my hair in particular. I don't like a too red of an eyebrow brow product kind of deal. So this one is, it's not quite neutral. It doesn't have that grayish cool undertone, but it's not red red like a lot of other drugstore brow products are. So I think it matches pretty well. I was looking at it in the sunlight today just to see how it would suit me, and I think it's really nice. So it's not too cool toned, but it's also not really a neutral either, and it's kind of a bit on the warm side, but it's not too red. So it's a decent little color for me, and I think that it's a really cool little deal with the spoolie on the one end and the actual product on the other end, and it's not sharpening. You don't have to go and find your sharpener to use it. You just roll it on up and it starts to work. So I think that's very cool. I would definitely give this a try. e.l.f. stuff is so affordable. I mean, it's just, sometimes it's just fun to just find random stuff and then see how it works out for you. So those were all the items that I kind of had been thinking about getting and I really had planned on picking up from e.l.f. whenever I did put in an order. So these were a couple things that I kind of got extra, kind of just threw in there in order to get to the $25 mark so that I could get free shipping. So here I have the lip exfoliator, which looks like a lipstick, but it's like sugary and stuff, like textured in there, so you just like move it all over your lips like you would any other lip product kind of deal, and it will exfoliate it away. It's kind of gross if you think about it, because it's probably got all your dead skin cells and stuff on it, which is, I don't know about that, but I think it works pretty well. So it does have a little bit of a moisture left over, kind of like it has some kind of oil in there, so it's not totally just drying and exfoliating away all the crap on your lips. So I will see how this works in the long run. I know my sister has one and she really enjoys it, and I know it's a pretty popular e.l.f. item, so I'm going to be trying that out and see how it works in the long run, but this morning I did enjoy using it. And lastly, I have a blush, just because I needed to throw something in there. This is the Pressed Mineral Blush in the color Sweet Retreat, and I did go online to see, like, other swatches and a blog post and stuff on this particular line of blushes. I think there are four of them, and this was the lightest one that I thought would probably suit my very fair skin tone pretty well. So it's what I have on today. A little bit heavy today. It's kind of strange to me. When I first put it on, it looked like it was pinky, and it had a bit of a nice, kind of almost corally kind of flush, very natural looking flush to my cheeks, but when I built it up another layer, it looks kind of orangey, like it has that bit of a corally orangey kind of tint to it. I don't know exactly what it's looking like on camera for you guys, but it's just kind of interesting. It looked really pink at first, and now it's kind of almost like it's oxidized or something, and it has a little bit more orange to it. So those were all the things that I picked up from e.l.f. recently. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If there are any items from e.l.f. that you really, really love or that you've been on the hunt for trying to get your hands on, let me know down in the comments below. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye!